हरे कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा एवरीवन, आई लाइक टू हार्टली वेलकम यू ऑल ऑफ यू फॉर टुडेज भगवद गीता सिंप्लीफाइड सेशन 3। सो थैंक यू सो मच फॉर जॉइनिंग। लेट मी शेयर माय स्क्रीन। आर एबल टू सी माय स्क्रीन प्रो?
यस प्रो जी।
Okay, let me put it to the slideshow. So just starting, we were today's session, like how we did yesterday. Like yesterday I asked about how many of you read Bhagavad Gita, second chapter, 13th verse. Maybe today I want all of you to read. I hope you have read. So today I want to ask all of you like one question so that we all can interact. Like what you do to be happy? Like I just want to all of you can put your answer in chat, or if you want to ask, if you want to say something, you can unmute also. You can raise your hand. Suppose you'll unmute you. Like one or two answers I want to hear. Like if you want to be happy, what you are going to do?
Hare Krishna Prabhu.
Hare Krishna Prabhu. Yeah.
Daily by morning times by chanting 16 rounds of. Hare Krishna mantra, and then going through Bhagavad Gita literature regularly, I find happiness in me.
Hari Bol, very nice, Roji. Your good name?
Ramachandra Prabhuji.
Ramachandra, Hare Krishna. Amazing. So you are happy by connecting with the Lord through his chanting the names of Lord. Reading a lot of scriptures. Amazing point, bro. Yeah. That's where what we all have to come to, the platform what Proji is doing. Very nice, bro. So many also said that some people said, I like what I interested to be happy. So different likes are there. People have different likes. Most of them said that, two people said that, I would like be happy when I spend time with family. So when get together happens, so all family people come together, we feel happy. One person said, I get more money, I'll be happy, and a good job and flat. Like, I think Ravipati Prabhu is saying that I'll be happy when I have money, more money, and I have good job or good flat. So like that, see, everyone have different kind of things. Yeah, thank you so much for sharing. So Ishita Madam is saying that reading scriptures, so nice. When I'm nearer to God, I feel more happy. Nice, very nice. So like, yeah, very nice answers you have given. So yeah, thank you so much. So today's session, like as Prabhuji said, there will be two things. One, we'll discuss about happiness. What is all we are searching for? That is happiness. We all know that everybody is searching for happiness. No one will search for misery. And second thing also, we'll be looking at understanding the basic understanding of karma today. So next session, we'll go deeper into karma. Understand different types of karma and other things. This session we are focusing on two topics. So session 3 is about what is real happiness and how to get that. And we'll see how human beings are superior than animals. So how in what they were superior, we'll go into see today. So before starting our today's session, and I will request all of you, like how we are doing everyday prayers. Today in a group, so one of the Mataji requested that she also want to recite prayers along with us. So I just made that screenshot so that we all can recite. Like when I'm reciting, maybe you can read to so it will be easy for all of you also. I just made that slide. So we'll quickly do our prayers for today. We'll pray so intensely that we are able to understand the spiritual subjects. Without the mercy of spiritual master, all the acharyas, we're not able to understand the Bhagavad Gita. So we need to pray before starting our Bhagavad Gita session. So we'll pray. ॐ अज्ञानतिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकय तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः नमो विष्णुपादाय
नमो विष्णुपादाय
कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले
गौरवाणी
प्रचारि
पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे
श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य
प्रभु
नित्यानंद
गदाधर
श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद
हरे कृष्ण
कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे हरे
कृष्ण हरे हरे
हरे राम हरे राम
हरे राम
हरे राम हरे राम
राम राम हरे हरे
राम
राम हरे हरे
हरे कृष्ण
हरे.
Thank you so much for reciting. So nice that all of you recited along with me. Yeah. Before starting for today's session, we'll just recap what we have discussed yesterday. Like generally our tendency is that we forget what we discussed. So better to recap and get into the flow what we discussed, and we'll continue with our today's session. So yesterday we discussed about who is Ishvara. So Ishvara means Sanskrit word, I discussed that, is the controller who controls all of us, and is a supreme controller. We discussed about from different scriptures like Brahma Samhita, Srimad Bhagavatam, they said about who is that mastermind behind this mysterious universe, and who is the supreme personality of Godhead, who is supreme controller, he is Krishna. So we read from the Brahma Samhita one verse, Ishvara Parama Krishna Sachitananda Vigraha Anadir Adir Govinda Sarvakarana Karanam. So we read that verse and we saw that how Krishna is mentioned as the supreme personality of Godhead there, and he is the cause of all causes. And also we have gone through Srimad Bhagavatam verse where we understood that all the incarnations are like Amsha of the Lord, and Krishna is Swayam Bhagavan. And the main person who is managing, creating, maintaining the universe, we understood the way how the government is working here under the direction of Prime Minister. Similarly, we also saw the universal government is under the direction of Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna. We understood that, right? And also we discussed about understanding of God. So understanding of God, we saw in like 1, 2, 3. There are three levels of understanding. So like first level of understanding of God is like God is all pervading through his energies. Through his energies, through his potencies, everything is God's energies. So Lord is all pervading. And second, we understood the second level of understanding is Lord is like a Paramatma who is 400 form situated in the region of heart in all of us, in all the living entities. So Paramatma is the feature of the Lord, is who is there with us always. He'll never leave us. He'll be with the soul always. So Lord will never leave us, like Paramatma. And second level is Paramatma. The third level we understood about the highest realization, that is Bhagavan feature of the Lord, that is personal form of the Lord, like how we are, like Lord is like that, having Tribhanga Shyama Sundaram, like in the three bent form, like Lord is there in spiritual world. So that is the topmost realization of the Lord. How to understand the Lord? We understood the example of sun. So how sunshine is spread everywhere, all pervading. By seeing sunshine, we can say sun is there. So, but sunshine is energy of the Lord. Similarly, Lord is also having his energies all everywhere pervading. That is Brahman feature of the Lord. Second, we studied about Paramatma feature is compared to sun disk. So that is also understanding of Lord. That is also sun only, but that is not, that's the gross level of understanding still. Because like Paramatma, we understood that Lord is then everyone's living entity. But exactly the soul belongs to spiritual world. So where they have, we have a relationship with Lord there. So the highest form of realization is understanding the Bhagavan feature of the Lord. It is compared to Surya Bhagavan. He is a personal form. So how sunshine, sun disk, and then sun God, who is a person, is called as Vivaswan. As Krishna explained in Bhagavad Gita also, fourth chapter. Explained that I have given this knowledge of Bhagavad Gita to sun God, Vivaswan, millions of years ago. So Vivasvan is the name of sun god. So that's the understanding of God. We understood like in three levels. The topmost realization we understood as Bhagavan, feature of the Lord. And also we discussed in detail about Bhagavan means, Bhaga means opulences. Van means one who possesses those opulences. He is Bhagavan. And also we studied about why Lord in advents and how. So Lord comes to this material world. We discussed the verse in Bhagavad Gita, 4th chapter, 8th verse. Paritranaya sadhunam vinashaya duskutam dharma samsthapanarthaya samvavami yuge yuge. So Lord advents in this material world to protect the devotees, to annihilate the demons, and to re-establish the dharma. Lord comes again and again. Millennium after millennium, Lord comes. And Lord comes to attract all of us also, saying that, hey, you are staying in this material world, but this material world is not permanent place. It's a temporary place. And it is not your residence. Your residence is a spiritual world. And it attracts through different kinds of pastimes he do. So, and it reminds us, all of us, whenever he comes, saying that you will be happy when you are back to the spiritual world. So, and also Lord advents in avatars as he come, and also different ways we studied. We also studied that Lord comes in form of different acharyas in parampara. He gives us bona fide paramparas where you can understand the knowledge. We get initiation from that bona fide parampara and practice that knowledge in our life. Like we discussed about Sri Vaishnava parampara, Brahma Madhva Gauda Vaishnava parampara, and we studied about Kumara parampara, Rudra parampara, but different acharyas are leading that parampara. And next we also discussed how Lord comes in the form of scriptures. Like we all just said that how you'll be happy means, you all said that, most of them said that they'll be reading scriptures, chanting the names of Lord. Like Lord came in the form of scriptures to give us association. So, and also to understand our real identity, like Bhagavad Gita scriptures, Srimad Bhagavatam, like Vedas, Upavedas, and there are so many like this we discussed in last class. And what is our role? After understanding this, so much of we understood that we have been put into this material world, and we are in this place where the place which we are not supposed to be. Like I told example of fish supposed to be in water, soul supposed to be with Lord. That is our eternal nature, because we are soul, part and parcel of the Lord. Lord is Satchit Ananda. Soul is also Satchit Ananda. Eternal. Sat means eternal. Chit means full of knowledge. Ananda means full bliss, always happy. So today the topic is that Ananda, bliss. So we'll go into that after this. So understanding our role is very important. Aligning our actions towards the Lord's plan, and we have to follow whatever Lord said in the scriptures. That is our role. So by following that, whatever Lord said, we are aligning to him, and we'll reach our supreme destination. That is going back to the supreme Lord in the spiritual world. So that is very important. And in the course, like we understood that whatever we have done till now, we understood that we supposed to do it in the right way. We did so many things. Now we are understanding the right way of doing it, aligning with Lord's scriptures, Lord's holy name chanting. So especially we discussed about chanting. We say an example about parrot in cage. Like the person comes and just polish the cage and he goes away without feeding the parrot. Like that, we understood that we are soul. Now our needs of soul to understand, right? We discussed that the need of the soul or food of the soul is to chant Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. So, and I also explained that how that mantra is prescribed by acharyas in Kali Yuga. And we can, today we'll practice that chanting, and that today onwards we are going to see personal experience. Most of you are already chanting, but who are all not, definitely please, today my humble request, chant with us for 1 minute the Prabhupada chanting together. So we'll do it for today. So that's all about what I want to discuss in the part of recap. And we will see today's topic. The most interesting topic, like, see this person in the picture, what he's doing is putting, am I searching for something, right? So actually what he's searching for. So every person is like that only. So we are all searching for so many things. Like one person searching for happiness, other person searching for maybe misery. No, right? Everyone is searching for happiness only. So we all want happiness in our life. So no one wants misery, no one wants suffering. We always want to be happy. So why? Because the soul's eternal nature is to be always happy. That is called joy, eternal joy. So blissful. Soul want to be always to be happy. So that's why everyone wants to search for happiness in many, many ways that we will see today in lecture. But what does scripture say about this? So scripture say, very nice verse here. We'll read the verse. I'll read the verse slowly. We can hear. Again, we'll recite the verse later in one of the slides. Ahara nidra bayamaitu namcha samanyametat pasubirna ranam dharmohitesham adiko visheshu dharme nahina pasubishamana. So the scripture says that both animals and humans share the activities of eating, sleeping, mating and defending. But the special property of humans is that they are able to engage in spiritual life. Therefore, without spiritual life, humans are on the level of animals. It's from Hitopadesha. So this verse I'll just tell in short, and we want to discuss this in detail in further slides. Like, what does this verse say is, we will see that there are four things common in animals and human beings. If you observe animals around us, there are four things categorized like very common things between animals and human beings. And scripture says that those four things are ahara, eating, nidra, sleeping, bhaya, means defending, fighting, defending, maitunam, means mating. So these four things are common in animals and also human beings. If human being does the same, because these are common, like animals also doing, we are also doing. If human beings also does the same, then they are equal to animals only, right? What will make the human being superior to animals is something called dharma. That is manusha dharma, what he has to do. So that dharma will make him adhiko vishesho. That will make him adhika vishesha. That will make him something superior to animals. So if he don't do it, dharmena hina pasubhis samana. Very easy to understand. Will be equal to pasu, means animals. So let's understand this in detail. Like why Shastra said it? Because one line I can say, that essence of this line is that human form of life is very rare. It is not like other forms of life. As I told in last class, there are total 84 lakh species of life. There are 9 lakhs of species under the water. There are beasts. That different kinds of living species are there. But human form of life is very, 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 very rare. And that form of life has to be utilized very nicely. So we'll discuss that, how it is. That so rare life, how we are doing in our current scenario. Like we search for happiness in life, right? Different ways, like individual level, family level, society level. We do that, right? So how to say individual level, like we want to crack seat into a IIT. So we study well and we felt that if I go into IIT, I'll be very happy. So if you go to IIT and you got the seat and there, if you get first rank, I'll be happy. So like that, we keep on having different levels of happiness. And although that happiness we may get for some period of time, and then again it lasts, it will not be there. So it is a temporary happiness what we are having, and it keep changing. So like, for example, childhood, we may have some activities, something we see for some time, we play for some time, but when you go adult, we will not feel that again to do it. So we'll keep changing that happiness. And that happiness never lasts for long. So, and also similarly family. So we have family, as we discussed that we feel happiness when we are together. But the separation of the family will again make us suffer, correct? But happiness will be there when we are together. But when that's separated, that we'll feel a lot of misery. We'll suffer there. So, but at family level also, we find happiness, correct? When we are coming together, we eat together, we spend time together, we feel happy. That really we feel happy. But this material world, if you see, the way we are staying, that earth planet. So we feel that when the separation comes, we'll really feel very pain in the heart. So that happiness also doesn't stay so long. So it is like temporary only. And society level happiness. So we build communities, my caste, my country, my nation. So we build community level happiness, but at this level time. But even if there is some kind of mistake there, or some kind of anything happened, again, broke into tears or broke into different kinds of fights and riots. So like that, we have different levels, like individual level happiness, which never lasts, family level happiness. We search for family level happiness. And also we do social level happiness. So a lot of things we search happiness in our life in different ways. So and also like all these things are satisfied, like family, individual, societal happiness. So people are there who are already satisfied with all these things, still they are searching for happiness. What I should do more, what I can do that I'll get more happiness. And they are not still satisfied, not content. So they want more, how to do it. Example, I'll tell, like hippies in US. There is a culture called hippies in US in 1970s or 60s, like that, where the people are there, where they have everything. They have high education. They are kind of PhDs. They have high parentage, very highly educated parents, very nice families. And they have very good society. What they did, we have everything, but still we need more. We need more. Let's try different things. So going extreme. So they went to extreme kind of taking drugs. And they do everything on the road. So they don't care. They do illicit sex. So all these kind of different things they did. So to search happiness. I want more. I want more. So still they are not content, are not satisfied. So with all these things. So like example, I'm saying like that. So people keep on searching for happiness in life in different ways, but still they are not completely satisfied. And there is any some mistake, again, going to depression. And as I said, that happiness doesn't last for long. So it'll end with the body's end. And also we tend to, like you see the extremes, I said, these extremes also make us suffer. Not that happiness lost, along with happiness, there will be suffering also. So we'll not be completely happy and eternal happy. So why? Because we will see there is endless search, as I told. So we keep on searching from childhood to adult age in different ways of searching happiness. So we assume happiness means improving multiple things. Multiple things are example, eating. So eating different kinds of foodstuffs. Like I'll just keep open all, sorry. Yeah. So we have, like I told that there are four things common, right? Between animals and human beings, eating, sleeping, mating, and defending. I was explaining that, like we assume happiness means improving these standards in different way, grades. Like animals may eat on the road. We eat in the hotel or in home, different kinds of foodstuffs. They sleep on the road. We sleep in nice pillows, nice. That grades we are keep on increasing ourselves, correct? Whatever we do whole day, we work for what? We think that for eating. We want to enjoy eating and we want to enjoy sleeping a long time. I want to sleep. So we enjoy mating, different, going to extremes. And then defending. Like defending means like animals fight, right? Whenever someone comes to that region, the dog barks. We want to protect ourselves, keeping grills our home safe. Someone comes to fight. So like that, we defend ourselves with so many equipments. So we keep defending ourselves. Like these four things, we seek improvement in these areas to the extent where I can be happy, seeking happiness in these things. Right? So you all agree with me? If you agree with me, can you chat in the chat window as? Or you have some different answers? Because next, going to the next slide, I'll just tell about this. Let me see the chat. Okay. Yes, yes. Yes, agree. Thank you. Thank you so much for your answers. Yeah, thank you. So let me explain you now. This, we really observe that the four things are common, animals and human beings. And also, as I explained earlier, that what we are seeking happiness, even animals also do the same. Animals also have friends. Animals also have fun. Animals also have family. So they also have all these things. So humans also have, animals also have. Then what is the difference? They also find happiness in all those things. So, and as I said that human beings eating, animals also eating, we are also sleeping, animals also sleeping, we are also mating, we are defending, animals also defending. So, but we are in different grades of making that is like, we are saying that is the advancement we are doing. So, but is that a real advancement? We have to question ourselves. Let's think that one second, just put a thought. I'm also doing same thing every day. I'm also doing same thing every day. Then what makes the human being superior to animals? That's the question to ask all of us. We should ask ourselves. What makes human being superior to animals? Can anyone tell? Anyone chat, give an answer? This is an interesting point. I just want to make sure that you are understanding consciousness, karma, good, animals, ability to think, right point, Vishasar, okay, bhakti, very nice, Tattam, ma'am, Mataji, okay, Valli, Mataji, what she said, humans can think, yes, animals also can think, ability to judge right or wrong, that's nice point, being spiritual, yes, able to think good and bad, civilization, yes, very nice points you all said, rightly you said. So like animals act on impulse, like they don't see, for example, if you keep fruit like a fruit shop, bananas are kept, bull will come, it will snatch that banana, it will go, it will eat it, but human beings will not do it, right? So animals act on impulse, but human beings think. So but that is one scenario, but even animals also think, animals also have intelligence, animals also they have that capacity. So let's see that more, but just Prabhuji can poll once, that I want you to understand that common things you all agree, you know, you all replied me, just we had that one poll that we just want to check with all of you that the four things are common, right? You agree with me, right? That you already mentioned, and you can answer the poll also. Okay. Yeah. Some in the chat, they answered that humans have intelligence. So some told about real, they answered it saying that animal doesn't have karma, human beings have karma. Human beings have karma. So some already told that all these, they gave some answers, but others to understand that animals lack intelligence. No, animals have intelligence. We have seen, right? You see so nicely spider constructs the web, birds having their nests. So they are very intelligent, going in the morning, coming in the evening, keeping the food ready. So they are very, very, very intelligently they plan their things also, right? Then they also have intelligence. Then what makes human being superior to animals? We should give a thought there. What makes the human being superior to animals? Is both are same? Humans are same, animals are also same? No, right? Human beings are superior. You are agreeing with that. So how human being is superior? If you consider this task, there are different kinds of animals here. So there is eagle, there is horse, there is dog, there is elephant, polar bear, and a cuckoo, and there is man. You see, there are different kinds of animals here. So you all know this animal, eagle. Eagle, what is specialty of eagle? Can anyone say? Anyone put in chat? Specialty of eagle? Any idea? See from far. Who is that? Abhipati Prabhu. Hare Krishna. Thank you, Prabhu. Sharp eye. Yes. Taman Prabhu. Yeah. So our eyesight compared to eagle's eyesight. Eagle can see from far. Even you can see from such a long distance, you can easily find the things which are there closer. So find the snakes from that such a far place. So we cannot have that superpower of eyesight. Horse can be very agile, very fast in riding. But human beings, we are not that fast or agile, right? And dog, sense of smell, it can smell for so long distances. But our sense of smelling is limited. Strength of elephant, like polar bear capacity to sleep, we cannot sleep that long, right? Like that, there are different kinds of species we see that they are superior to human beings in different senses. Correct, no? Then what makes this us superior? Our senses are limited compared to these animals, right? As I always said, like human beings have higher intelligence. So, but animals, whatever they do, animals, whatever they do for only these four things: eating, sleeping, mating, and defending. They do all the activities throughout their life, throughout their day, for these four things only. If human beings also do these four things, okay, just pause again. Human beings also, we do our whole day activities for doing these four things, then it is not correct. Human beings has to do dharmo hitesham adhiko visheshu, because the intelligence was given to human being to think about who am I, why am I suffering? Very important questions. Who am I? Why am I suffering? all of us know that we are suffering this material world. We are suffering here, correct? Because of different reasons, which we are going to explain in detail in next session. So, but we are all suffering here, correct? And we should understand, who am I? Because can here any animal, for example, dog can come and tell that I want to go to temple. I want to understand why am I suffering. No, right? They will just take birth and they will die without knowing why they have taken birth. Why am I dying? Why the family is given to me and why the family is taken back? Who is doing all these things? What is the purpose of my life? They will not think about it, correct? The human beings are able to think about it. Human beings should think about it. So we should understand, like, why we have given that superior power. So, as I said, animals are even better than human beings. Animals have racial power and intelligence. But still, human being should think that he has this intelligence to always think, who am I? Why am I suffering? Although we have a lot of advancement in science, like we have rockets, we have laptops, we have Apple Watch, so we have Apple laptops, so many things are there. Although we are so advanced in our technology and other stuff, still we are not at all having the real understanding that who are we exactly, why am I suffering? Although a lot of medicines are there, right? Is there any full stop to our suffering? No. Still suffering is there in this material world. Suffering is there. So still death is there. Nobody can stop death. Nobody can stop birth. Nobody can stop old age. Nobody can stop disease. So all these are real problems of life. Birth, old age, disease, and death. Although we have a lot of advancement, we don't have anywhere full stop for these four things. Nobody can. So that's why, despite of this advancement of so much, human beings are still having a lot of depression, a lot of anxiety, a lot of suicides. So dissatisfaction, and we are unhappy. Although we have so many things. So because we always tend to have advancement, which will make us like click a button, it does everything, right? It cleans the house, it cleans the clothes, it run the mixie, like one button remote does everything. Click a button, food will come to home. Like that, on the click of button, we are doing all these activities which make us life more and more comfort for especially these four things, which will not give the true inner joy to heart. So, and not understanding the real needs of soul, what will happen? Man going to depression, keeping him in the center. I am, my need, my want. It is not satisfied, my senses, I am going to hit you. I am going to fight with you. So we keep ourselves in center and we wrongly identify ourselves and we try to do these four things in different grades. So that's why we are, although having so much of technology advancement, we see that people are still dissatisfied. There's a lot of full of anxiety and they are stressed. So that's the main thing. So if you see, in the same case, animals, there are no rights, there are no suicides. In human being, if there is, like if I don't pass in a subject, we commit suicide. So if there is any small change in some kind of policy, people start rioting. Like that, in animals, those things are not there at least. But human beings, we have. We should always, superior to animal, that superiority means understanding, as I explained, that we have to understand that, who am I, why am I suffering? These two questions we have to think, and we have to understand those questions so nicely. If you are not doing that, then you are equal to the two-legged animals. Like animals, as a verse explained, the same thing, that we are be the two-legged animals. Now, I'll recite this verse. Now you'll understand very nicely. You can also recite. You can be muted, but you can recite. Ahara nidra bayamaitu namcha.
Ahara nidra
bayamaitu
namcha.
Samanyametat pasubir naranam.
Samanyametat pasubir naranam.
Dharmohitesham adiko vishesho.
Dharmohitesham adiko vishesho.
Dharmena hina pasubir samana.
Dharmena hina pasubir samana.
Now, if you are not following the dharma, we are doing these four activities. Ahara nidra baya maitunam. Ahara means eating, nidra means sleeping, baya means defending, maitunam means mating. So So if you are doing these four activities only, then what will happen? We are equal to the animal, the two-legged animal. You can see the pictures there. So nicely they have mentioned. Although we have other part of the body, we look like animal. That means well-dressed animal, because our activities are like that only, similar to animal. But if you do these four activities only, then scriptures say that we are equal to animals. We have to do dharma, that is manush dharma. Understand why I am here, why I am taking birth. Birth itself is a problem. We are in 9 months in womb and we are suffering, lot of suffering in the womb. Like we assume if a person inside a darkest place for 1 day is enough, not even 9 months, you think 1 day is enough, fully dark and there are a lot of germs biting him. That itself is suffering. And then birth, old age, we all grow old in our life, correct? So nobody wants old age. We'll get old. That is also pain. And nobody wants disease, we'll get disease. So like that, we'll see that we have to understand why I'm getting all these things. Animals never think about it, correct? No? Human beings have to think. Human beings have this intelligence to think this thing. Not that if I get money, I'll be happy. If I get flat, I'll be happy. Although you get flat, then you'll think that flat is there, but I don't have TV. I need a 55-inch TV. And then I'll be happy. Then I'll think that I need a car. Then I'll be happy. No. Car is there, but I want something else. So like that, we keep on changing our rates of happiness. That will not satisfy us internally. Which will make us eternally happy and satisfied is when we think about us and connect to God by the spiritual practices. That will make us the real happy, the soul, which is a soul, will make us real happiness. So, dharmohitesham adhiko vishesho dharmena heena pasubhishamana. Dharmena heena, if there is no dharma, pasubhishamana, we will be equal to pasu. Dharmohitesham adhiko vishesho, we have to do our dharma, that will make us superior to animals. That's the point. So, just one more poll, like whatever we discuss this point, I want all of you to answer it so that you are in agreement with me about this point. Akshay Prabhu, can you please take the second poll? Can you just answer this? Yes. Quickly? Yeah. Nice. It's really true, right? Even we feel ourselves, we see these four things, no science can stop. Can science stop old age? No. Can science stop disease? No. Still diseases are there. There is virus come up, right? There are like that. Diseases are there because of our actions. So thank you so much for your poll. Thank you for poll. Let's go further. Very, very important. This, whatever we discussed till now, like just summarize in one line. There are four things common between animals and human beings. That is eating, sleeping, mating, and defending. That thing which makes human beings superior to animals is higher intelligence. That is the thinking, whatever you answered, that will make superior only when human beings find out the cause of sufferings, to inquire the purpose of life, to harmonize our life with God and nature, to attain the eternal happiness. That is our goal. Because soul's nature is attain that eternal happiness, not the short living happiness for some time. So these are the four main things we have to, human beings have to do it. We all have to do it. So that is what tells that we are having this higher intelligence. So very, very important. To find out cause of sufferings, we'll get to know in next sessions that there are different kinds of sufferings. Like I was explaining, I think I didn't explain, but there are three kinds of sufferings. Adhyatmika, Adhibhautika, Adhitaivika. The scriptures explain about it. So Adhyatmika means suffering because of our own body and mind. So we get different diseases, we get headache. So different kinds of diseases we suffer. That's because of our own body and mind. Second, we suffer because of other living entities like mosquitoes, terrorists, like different kinds of animals, snakes, Adhibhautika. Adhidaivika means suffering because of natural calamities like floods, hurricanes, like that. So like that, there are different kinds of sufferings we are in this material world. We have to find, like now we just, because of reading scriptures, we understand that we're suffering because of these three, we're suffering, and how to come out of it. And then we have to understand how to inquire the purpose of life. So if I see this phone, someone manufactured this phone, right? There should be a purpose for it. If I see laptop, there is some purpose for it. If I see a watch, there is some purpose for it. They made some purpose. Similarly, if you see humans, what we are, we made for some purpose. The purpose is to understand who are we, and we have to revive that love, loving relationship with the Lord again, and to align with the Lord's plan, to harmonize our life with God and nature. We have to be aligned with the nature also. So that is very, very important. If you go against the nature and the Lord's law, we will see the consequences currently what's happening in our world. There are so much of diseases, so much of adharma happening. So we will see all those things. So we have to harmonize our life with God and nature. And we have to attain the eternal happiness means, eternal happiness means the place where there is no birth, there is no old age, there is no disease, there is no death. That is spiritual world. So that is the place where you all want to go back. That is spiritual world. So that's the main key thing what human beings have to do. Because if you see animals, as a concluding point, animals, what do? Animals cannot come to a temple. Animals cannot gather like how all of us gathered now. We are all very interested to learn about Bhagavad Gita, learn about who are we. So we are all very interested. Can animals do it? No. Animal doesn't have that capability. And animals doesn't just lead their life and then die. So human beings also does like cats and dogs, then there will not be, it will not be the right thing. Then we lose our opportunity where Lord has given us the human form of life to do all these four. So that way, that is the only way where we can, it's the only human form of life is the only way which will help us to achieve that goal. So as I said, that 4 points, it was like inquiring, understanding who am I, where am I come from? So how I was taken into my mother's womb and how I'm progressing in my life, how the what is death? So all these questions are answered. So here is the nice verse from Srimad Bhagavatam, first canto, first chapter, first verse. So Janmadasya etonvaya itaratas chatvesva bignaswarat. So here it is explained that the understand the original creator who creates everything and where is he residing in the spiritual world. So now he has important knowledge to and Brahma and how that knowledge has come down. So like that, understanding the higher authorities, like higher dimensions, like understanding the importance of where you have come from. There is a place where we are earlier and now we are now currently, because that journey has made so many lifetimes that we have come till here. So we have to understand that how it has happened. So and who is that person who, and that absolute truth means the real truth. Who is that absolute truth? So which will never change. It will be always constant. That absolute truth. Who is that supreme personality of Godhead, Krishna? And our goal should be again going back to Godhead. Like just to give an overview, if you see the picture over there, like Srimad Bhagavatam is scripture. It's Amala Puranam. It's one of the Puranam. And you can see in the first verse only explained about the creation. Who is that supreme creator? If you see in the picture, like here is Parikshit Maharaj. And here it is Sukadeva Goswami. He is the Vyasadeva's, Veda Vyas son. And he is Parikshit Maharaj, is the grandson of Arjuna. So hearing 7 days about Srimad Bhagavatam. So understanding the importance of life, what is death, asking very, very relevant questions to Sukadeva Goswami, understanding the importance of human form of life. So in 7 days and 7 nights, they discussed Srimad Bhagavatam. Total 18,000 verses they have discussed, and his life got perfected after hearing from Sukadeva Goswami. And also, like I told, a lot of energies of Lord are there. We'll discuss more, like material energy. Durga Devi is taking care of material energy. She is having the Trisulam, which will she'll be making us act in this three modes and these three kleshas I told you. Adhyatmika, Adibhautika, Adhyavika. So she will be taking care of all those. And above all, this is spiritual world where Lord resides there, and we also resided there and we have come down. So like that, we will understand, inquiring more, understanding the deeper aspects of where we have come from, what is, who is absolute truth. So we will have that goal that we want to get out of all these sufferings and we want to enter into the loving relationship with the Lord. So like I said, birth, old age, disease and death are the problems. We all know that we are suffering. So that's eternal life, eternal joy, happiness we'll get. Again, we connect back to the Lord. So connecting back to the Lord, just I want to narrate with a short story. So as a, in sync with, I just want to check the time also, but very nice and short story. Before starting the story, I just forgot to update all of you. If you have any questions, as I explained earlier, our Sankarshna Prabhu may be already assisting all of you in chat. If you have further more questions, you can chat there. Our Prabhuji will answer all of your questions. And at the end, again, we'll take the Q&A. So now, just short story, very nicely, I'll explain you that connecting back with the Lord and how Lord is eager for all of us. So the story of prodigal son, like there is a very rich person, like kind of Tata or Birla kind of person, very rich. He has a son, like who always, like he was like pampered from kind of, like he's very rich, right? So that he, whatever his father gives money, buys a pocket money, go and spends the money a lot. So every day he just spends the money, chills out and come back. So like that he was doing every day. So he was felt like every day I'm going to ask him, it will be difficult. Let's ask him the share. And as the friends told, you just take the share and come, then we will do much more. So he go and asked his father very stubbornly, give me my share. So if you give me a share, I'll go and enjoy myself. So he thought that friends told him and he wants to go and do more and more enjoy outside. So father told, no, it is not correct what you're doing. You definitely will suffer, but he's very stubborn. If you don't give me, I will commit suicide. I'll do whatever I want. He was so stubborn that I want the share. So unwillingly, father gave him. He knows that he will be spoiled. So he took it and he went and he just again did the same thing. So that person, all the friends are there with him till the time money is there with him. Once money is over, all friends are gone. There is no friends. So time passed. So he spent everything. And what happened to that son? So that son actually, he went, he's on road now, nothing to eat. So
Prabhuji, you continue. I just
take it. Okay, yeah, thank you. I thought some internet disconnection. What happened? That son, he's on the road now. So he doesn't have any money to eat, doesn't have the place to stay. So he went searching in the roads. So he saw there is a place where a person is taking care of all the kind of different kinds of animals, pigs, cows. So he has come kind of poultry there, having there. So he went to that place and he was so hungry, didn't eat for so long because he spent everything now. He lavishly spent it. So what he did now, this person, he was so hungry, asked him, can you give something for me to eat? He went and asked that person who is taking care of that poultry. So that person gave him some foodstuffs, which that was given to that animals over there, pigs and who are all there, like different kinds of animals. That feeding thing he gave him, he ate it. So this same person earlier used to have high class food, but now this person is having the food which is giving to the animals. So he added and he told that you give me something, whatever you give, I'll be here, I'll work here. Whatever you tell, I'll work here and I'll be with you. So like that person he was there with him, the poultry person, and was eating there, whatever he gives, and he's staying there. He forgot about everything. That his father is a multi-millionaire billionaire, like rich persons, Tata or Birla. So he forgot and he stayed there. He stayed there and he was eating whatever is given there. So that person named him also like different name. He forgot his name also. He was just living over there. Once one of his father was searching where he went, was searching for long. So he didn't find him. One of the father's friend went through that way where he went. So, and he saw this person, this son sitting over there and having kind of tattered dresses, sitting there and eating all the nonsense there. So he saw and told, hey, you are the person, like you're supposed to be there with your father. You are writing here, eating this kind of stuff, leading this lifestyle. So please come, I'll take to your father. But he was embarrassed that how I can come. I just stubbornly took my share and I came out. How can I go back to my father? Then, your father is eagerly waiting for you. He's searching everywhere for you. He wants you to come back to him. So he was eagerly searching for you. So then he took to his father. Father came running towards him and hugged him. Where all you went these days? What is your dress? What are you doing? So father was very happy that he is back. So just like cut short the story, but the overall essence is this. Understand that we are like that son. This is the prodigal son story. We are like that son. We're supposed to be with our father in spiritual world. who is the person having everything there. There is no suffering, everything there. But we are very stubborn. Lord, I want to enjoy like you. Lord, we are envy towards the Lord. So we, what will happen that time? Okay, Lord, unwillingly will send us. We have different kinds of desires. So different desires we have. So enjoy independent of the Lord. To be a controller like the Lord, which are like not good. So what will happen, Lord? Unwillingly, Lord will leave us. So then what will happen? We'll come to this world and we'll forget everything. How the sun is rioting. So, but Lord will never leave us. As I explained earlier, Lord comes again and again. Lord comes as super soul in our heart. Lord comes as scriptures. So Lord gives us the opportunity to come back to him. So that's why we understood from this story very nicely that Lord is eagerly waiting for us. Now our ultimate goal is understanding that Lord and again going back to him. Lord will always welcome us. That's the point I want to make. I'll share again. There's one more analogy. We'll discuss that. So the key takeaway here is, like, as I discussed, that what is the problem and what is the solution? So what is the problem now? We all came to this material world and we are attached to the things. As this verse explains very clearly, Indriyarteshu vairagyam ahankara evacha janma mrityu jara vyadi dukkha doshanu darshanam. Bhagavad Gita 13th chapter 9th verse. So next it explains, the renunciation of objects of sense gratification, absence of false ego, the perception of evil of birth, death, old age and disease. So this verse explains that we all know that these four things, janma, mrityu, jara, vyadi, that means birth, janma means birth, mrityu means death, we all know, jara means old age, vyadi means disease. So janma, mrityu, jara, vyadi, all this means dukkha doshanu darshanam. It is dukkha only, it's not happy, it's dukkha. What we are getting here is material world, it's misery. So dukkha alayam ashashvatam, Krishna also says in Bhagavad Gita, that we see again and again, dukkha doshanu darshanam, anudarshanam. So we get again and again. Because of what? Reason is, we're attached to our things. For example, I'll just tell an example. If you purchase a new bike, very nice bike, and you come to a place, some person comes and take a rod and just hit on your bike. You'll feel that you got hit and you'll go and fight with him, right? We are thinking that bike is mine. That is mine, mine. So we are so much attached to it. If it something happens to it, we'll feel that pain. So for the material things only, we feel that much pain, that if you purchase a bike or purchase a car, someone touches it, we'll ready to fight with him. Like that, we are identifying ourselves with the body. How the person identifies that bike is mine. We are spirit soul, but we attach to this body. This body is mine. And these senses are mine. And whatever I want through these senses, I want to go and enjoy. Example, I want to eat gulab jamun. So if I want to eat gulab jamun, I'll eat. Well, my senses are saying eat more, eat more, eat more. But if you eat more, what will happen? We'll get indigestion. So we are going to satisfy senses through the body, cross body. And we are so much attached to the body that we tend to identify ourselves with this body only. So whatever gives happiness to the body, I'll try to do it. So that's why we are so much attached to this body. So that attachment gives us misery. What will give us happiness? Detachment. So how to get the detachment? We learn. So the detachment which gives happiness means we understand that we are the spirit soul and we are not this body. That's the knowledge first. We got the knowledge and we have to put that in practice. How to put that in practice? That's by chanting the names of Lord, reading the scriptures like Bhagavad Gita and hearing from the many seniors. Hearing also very important. By doing these activities, we will get the detachment. Detachment means what? Detaching ourselves from this object of sense gratification and attaching ourselves to very, very nice things in our life, like prasadam, deities, devotees, so scriptures like that. So that will make us more and more happy here also, in this life also. We'll be very, very happy. So that is very important. So main point is that we have to detachment, wrongly identifying us will give us misery. Rightly identifying us and rightly following the Lord's things will make us happiness. So that is very important. That is the key takeaway. And there is one story, very nice story in Ramayanam. You all of you know about this story, right? Like Kaikeyi in Ramayanam, you all know that Kaikeyi has two boons from Lord Dasarath. I'll not go in deep, but I'll just give the brief. Maybe all of you know also. And Kaikeyi asked Dasarath the two boons. One boon is that Lord Ram has to go to forest for 14 years and Bharat has to be made king. So, and also she told Ram, Ram has to wear all the dress, which kind of like barks of tree. So that he will not wear any kingly dress. No one will identify him. So he has to go for the Vanavasam. So like that, why she did? Because of attachment towards her son and me and mine. For me and for mine. For me and my mind. That is attachment. So she wants her own enjoyment. She is the center. Because if Ram becomes king, then Sita becomes the queen. Then where will be my position? Because Dasarath is not the king now. And Ram is the son of Kausalya. So then how? But Kaikeyi was good initially, but she was been polluted by the thoughts of Antara, hunchback lady. So she polluted the thoughts of Kaikeyi, and what she did, she made her change her mentality. So Kaikeyi asked Dasarath these boons, and then we all know that along with Ram, Lakshman and Sita Mata, they both went to the forest. When Bharat came back from his in-law's place, Bharat asked, where is Lord Ram? Then she told this, what all happened. Then he told one point that, do you think I'll be happy if Lord Ram goes to forest and you making me king? So he spoke very harshly to his mother that, how can you do this act? I don't want to even call you as my mother. So whatever she did, that thinking that I need this, I am attached to myself and my son, and I want this enjoyment for us. What made her happy? Because she wants to make Bharat as a king. That will make her happy. But what Bharat did? Bharat, he went to Ram and asked him, you become the king. I don't want to become the king. But Lord Ram told, no, already your father has given these words. I'll follow this. You please go back and rule. But Bharat, he was very dedicated to his Lord Ram. And he told how Lord Ram lived the life. Sorry, in the forest, I live the same kind of life here, like that only. And he led the life like that, staying outskirts in a kind of hut. So he led the very kind of very austerity life, like Lord Ram. So here Kaikeyi, she thought that she'll be happy, right, by doing this activity. She was like continuously in the kingdom, getting cursed from so many people. She was like completely fed up. Like, I thought that by making you king and sending Lord Ram to forest, we'll be happy. But what will happen is that became a curse in my life. So she again came to Bharat and told, I don't want to talk to you much, but I just want to request, can I stay with you? I cannot stay in the kingdom. Like that, she requested Bharat. So you see, now she wants to do one act for thinking that for her enjoyment. And what will happen now? That has made her only suffer because of that. So we can learn that from this pastime, right? So nicely. So most of us, we lead our life thinking those are the real enjoyments of our life. But the real enjoyment of our life is to love and serve the Lord. So, and most of the population currently live in this, how Kaikeyi left her life of 14 years of guilt. And then only she felt pacified after Lord Ram excused her after 14 years. So we should not lead that. We should always be very intelligent, like Arjuna, how we discussed. We always should be taking the path of the spirituality and chanting the names of Lord. So that's very important. You should not get attached to the things. So in the course of time, it's already like now 7:15:08. So I just want to go a bit fast now. So till now we discussed about the understanding of this real problems, and human intelligence has to be think that why we are suffering, who am I, where I come from. And Lord is eagerly waiting for us. We have to go back to the spiritual place where we're coming from. And also the main problem is that we are attached. And also there are some more problems which we really face in our life, like explained here. Like is explained in Bhagavad Gita 7th chapter 27th verse. Icha dvesha sammutena dvandva mohena bharata sarva bhutani sammoha సర్గే యాంతి పరాంతప ఓషియన్ ఆఫ్ భారత ఓ కంకర్ ఆఫ్ ద ఫో ఆల్ ద లివింగ్ ఎనిటీస్ ఆర్ బోర్న్ ఇన్ డెల్యూజన్ బివిల్డెడ్ బై డ్యువాలిటీస్ అరైజన్ ఫ్రమ్ డిజైర్ అండ్ హేట్ సో వి ఆల్ హ్యావ్ దిస్ ఫోర్ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ థింగ్స్ సో వి స్క్రిప్చర్స్ సే దట్ వి హావ్ ఫోర్ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ డిఫెక్ట్స్ ఫస్ట్ థింగ్ ఈస్ వి హావ్ ఇంపర్ఫెక్ట్ సెన్సెస్ వి హావ్ అవర్ సెన్సెస్ ఆర్ నాట్ సో పర్ఫెక్ట్ ఇఫ్ ద లైట్ ఈస్ ఆఫ్ కెన్ ఐ సీ మై ఓన్ హ్యాండ్ వీ కెనాట్ సీ అండ్ వీ హ్యావ్ టెండెన్సీ టు బికమ్ ఇల్యూజన్డ్ సేమ్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ అగైన్ ఇఫ్ ఐ సీ ఇఫ్ డార్క్ రూమ్ దెర్ ఇస్ ఎ రోప్ దెర్ ఐ ఫెల్ దట్ ఇట్ మే బి ఎ స్నేక్ ఐ మే బి అఫ్రేడ్ బికాస్ ఇట్ బికమ్స్ ఇల్యూజన్ ఐ కెనాట్ సీ ద థింగ్స్ యాజ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ టు కమిట్ మిస్టేక్స్ లైక్ వాట్ హ్యాపన్ ఇస్ వెన్ వీ టెండెన్సీ హ్యావ్ కమిట్ మిస్టేక్స్ టు ఎర్ ఈస్ హ్యూమన్ రైట్ వీ కెన్ కమిట్ మిస్టేక్స్ అండ్ వీ చీట్ అదర్స్ సో బికాస్ ఆఫ్ బికమింగ్ ఇల్యూజన్ వీ చీట్ అదర్స్ So we have seen the diagram that many people want to cheat many people, right? So we have a tendency to cheat. Like for example, I broke some glass. I want to escape. I'll make sure that that is clean and throw on the glass outside. So no one knows about it. And like this, we have four defects. But the person who is out of these four defects can help us. If the person is of the same material world and having the same defects, they cannot help. So that's why we are approaching Lord's scriptures, where is out of these four defects. So that's how now we are all attending this Bhagavad Gita simplified course where the Lord's words are spoken here aparusheya the words are doesn't have any defect so those words we are learning here like not like us having defects so by having those words in practice we'll definitely achieve the real goal of life and we'll be successful in this verse what is that main thing we have to learn is we understood that we have all these defects we have to come out of the defects by following the words of Lord. So that is called yoga. Means wants to link oneself with Krishna. Yoga means connecting the Lord and connecting ourselves. So the primary characteristic of yoga is that we know that there are different kinds of yoga where we do asanas and everything. But the real meaning of yoga is, you can go and check, that is about connecting the link between us and the Lord. That is the real yoga. So yoga means to link oneself with Lord Krishna by concentrating the mind on him and dotailing all our senses. So we have our senses. We can dotail to Lord. Eyes to see the Lord. So legs to walk to the temple, take darshan of the Lord. So like that, mouth or tongue to take prasadam, chant the names of Lord. Like we have to dotail all our senses in the Lord's service. And as if the ultimate happiness. So we just started with happiness. And we discussed that, but there are so many problems. And we understood that what will be the ultimate happiness is always to be spiritually connected. So how we spiritually connect? 6.6 Bhagavad Gita explains, Nasti buddhir ayuktasya, na chayuktasya bhavana, na chava ayataha shantir, ashantasya kutak sukam. I'll just read the translation. One who is not connected with the Supreme can have neither transcendent intelligence nor a steady mind, without which there is no possibility of peace. And how can there be any happiness without peace? So it explains that we should get connected to that Lord. Then only we'll be happy. Otherwise, we'll never be happy. So example, again, same example I'm quoting, fish out of water. So you should be in connection with water. Fish need to be connection with water. Otherwise, fish will die. Similarly, soul has to be in connection with the Lord. Then only soul will be happy and it will be peaceful. Otherwise, there is no kind of happiness or peace. That's very, very important. So the four things, inquiring about absolute truth, that Lord, who is the Supreme Lord, and why are you suffering, right? And what's the reason of our suffering? That we'll see. And we will be again having the ultimate happiness, how attain ultimate happiness, we understood. Like these are the main things we discussed today, like very, very important things, which makes the human being superior to animals. So let's, the fish out of water example. I just want to show you the picture again. Like you see the fish over here, right? Getting, like giving so much of TV, foods, every kind of enjoyment, newspapers, magazines, everything, but it'll never be happy. So the soul can only be satisfied by and happy in spiritual world, which is its natural home, just as fish will naturally be happy when put back in the water. It's a solid example where you can easily understand a soul's position and how we should get connected to Lord. So now conclusion, summary of like what have we discussed till now, like answer to all our problems, understanding our own identity, connect with our purpose of life, What is the purpose of our life? Why are we here? Teaches us the right mode of action. It's Bhagavad Gita teaches the right mode of action, that what we should do, what we should not do. It explains that we should do that action in such a way that will help us not to bond here. It helps us to take to the Supreme Lord, to set priority to solve critical problem. We have so many problems, but we'll set priority. Like how we set priority in our life, that first I will do this task in my office, second I will do this task. We have different priorities. Similarly, we will set priority to which is very important problem of our life. Like we all know that the important problems of life, now we discussed, like birth, death, old age, and disease. Those are the problems which we understand that the real problems of life, which everyone have, and nobody can stop it. Nobody can avoid it. So we all want to solve that critical problem by setting the priority of spiritual life, by reading Bhagavad Gita, understanding and practicing Bhagavad Gita, and to stay connected with the Creator. We have to stay connected with the Creator. So we always stay with the Creator who created us, and we should stay connected with Him always. So there is one poll. Prabhuji, if you can put that poll, let's see, like I discussed for a long time, because next topic is about karma. So give the brief understanding about karma. Before that, I would like to answer all of you this poll. Can all of you please answer for me this poll? So what makes human being superior to animal? Inquiring why am I suffering? What is the purpose of life? Connect to Supreme, we'll be happy. Or just eat, drink, and be happy. Just lead our life, whatever you want. No need to know about Supreme. So almost 40 out of 71 gave answers. I hope this kind of poll will help me that you are in connection, so that you are understanding what I'm trying to say. And also I am seeing a lot of questions in chat. I hope you are not getting disturbed and you are focusing on this concept also. Yeah, out of 70, 50 have given the answers. So others also can please go through it and read it. So the next important topic. So just summarize, we discussed right just now. So understand, human beings are superior to animals, and you have to think, why am I suffering? What is my ultimate goal of life? And we have to connect to that Supreme, then only we'll be the happy. So that is the eternal nature of the soul. So by doing all the activities which are explained in Bhagavad Gita, like chanting, hearing about God, so honoring prasadam, dating darship, all these things will help us to get connect to Lord, and will make us real happiness, real joy, eternal joy. Can experience in this life also, can experience after this life also. Yeah, thank you so much for your poll. So next most important topic, today we'll discuss brief in karma, and next session we'll go in deep about different kinds of karma and real life examples about karma. So what is karma? Just give an introduction, then we'll see a short video Prabhuji or Akshay Prabhu will play. The law is called karma. That law, for every action there is equal and opposite reaction. We all heard this statement, right? So the karma is like that. For every action what we do, there is an equivalent and we have a reaction for it. If we do a good act, I'll get good credits, pious credits. If you do a bad act, I'll get bad credits, kind of sinful activities. So every action, we will get something out of it back. That is called karma. So currently, for example, we see ourselves, we have taken birth in maybe, take example me, I've taken birth to my parents. I didn't take birth to some other rich family, right? Like just taken birth to our parents. But the person who take birth to like kind of Ambani or different kinds of family, they by birth, they have got that opportunity where they need not do anything. They have got a lot of wealth. So who decide this? Because based on their karma, what they have done in previous life, that made them take that birth. Correct, no? So some person may by birth, they born blind. So what mistake he did? Why he born blind at the birth only? Who decided that? Based on our activities in last life, we'll get that kind of reaction in our next life. So we'll just see like whether all things are destined or we have some free will on what to do with that free will. So Akshay Prabhu, can you please play that video? Please observe carefully this video now, and we'll discuss on it.
So his question is, how does luck or destiny, what role does it play in victory or success? Right? Is it all hard work? Is it all destiny? What is it? Now, in my humble opinion, destiny is the situations that come to you, which are beyond your control. For example, you didn't choose your parents. Did any of you choose your parents? You were destined. That was destiny. You were born. Aisa nahi bole, ye meri baap, ye meri maa, main avatar dunga inse. Have you ever thought like that? Never. Did you ever choose your looks? Aisa naak hoga, aisa bole. Did you choose? No one looks as good as their Facebook profile picture and no one looks as ugly as their Aadhaar card picture. No one. No one looks like that. Correct? So, situations. Situations are destiny. You didn't choose them. They came to you. If someone comes and insults me, I didn't choose it. It came to me. That situation is destined. But my response to those situations is my choice. Response is not destiny. What I choose is my choice. And when I choose it, that decides my future destiny. This is why they say man is the maker of his destiny, not situations. Situations will remain what they are, but how you respond to those situations is completely and entirely your choice. So now, for example, some of you may have just got admission in a mediocre simple college. Why? You couldn't crack it to go to IIT Mumbai. You couldn't crack it to any of those places. No issues, right? It's not that only IITians succeed, is it? You have that situation which is destined. Now you have a choice to work hard, to cultivate that attitude. That attitude is not destiny. That attitude is a choice. And when you choose that attitude, hopefully victory will come to you right away. Even if it doesn't come to you right away, you have sown the seed that will pay back. The seed that is sown will certainly fructify. Now, 10 years down the line, 20 years down the line, or later. This is why persistence, sticking it out, is so much essential. Thank you very much, sir.
Hare Krishna. I hope all of you have seen the video and you carefully observed it. So Gaur Gopal Prabhu so nicely explained that how our choices make our destiny. So we'll have our situations in our life, but how we respond to it is very important. Correct, no? So maybe yesterday also one of the devotee asked question, same question in the chat, no? He asked about how can everything is destined or everything is like in our hands. Like so nicely Prabhuji explained that we are the maker of our destiny. We have different kinds of situations in our life, but how we respond to it is very important. So we have to choose so nicely. We have to do such a, what are we choose in our life is very, very important. Now all of you, I'd like to really appreciate all of you. Like you have taken all of your time and you chose that you want to learn Bhagavad Gita. You want to learn about what Lord is saying to all of us. So I like to appreciate all of you for this thing. So nice that we understood that we are the maker of our destiny. So we should be very careful that where I'm going to destine in my next life. This life, we got opportunity to understand about Lord. So we should not misutilize it. We should always make the most of it and understand about the Lord. So let me share again. Sorry for that. So Prabhuji will share that link. Okay, and let me go to the next slide. Yeah. So as Prabhuji explaining that about the seed, right? We sow our seeds. So we do our activity that will be, it will reap us one day. Like for example, agriculture you take. So whatever you sow, so shall you reap. So whatever we put a seed, that tree only will come out. For example, if I sow mango seed, what will come out of it? Mango only. There is no kind of pomegranate or some other fruit. Whatever we sow, that's what we get it. So whatever action we do, that's very important in this life. So if you do an action which makes suffer other living entities, definitely we'll get a reaction to it in the next life. So you've seen a picture that man is butchering the cow there.
Your slide is not shared, please.
Okay, well, thank you so much. I think. Sorry. Let me share again.
Stop sharing and again sharing.
Yeah, I just stopped, Roji. Let me know once you can see my screen, probably.
Yes, Prabhuji.
Thank you, Prabhuji. Thank you for I'll just tell again. Like we probably were saying about seed, right? Whatever seed we sow, so astral retreat. So we have to carefully sow that. Now we are sowing the seed of mango, we'll get mango only, correct? If you sow mango seed, we'll not get some other fruit or something else. Similarly, what our action we do, that is very important. What our choice we make, what our action we make. So it's very important. So we do an action, for that we have an opposite reaction also. See, in the person killing a cow, definitely he will suffer because of is going against the Lord's law and giving the suffering to other living entities. Definitely he also will suffer, correct? So like that, for every action we do, it's very, very important that we get a reaction. So we should be aware and conscious about that. And that doesn't mean that we have to stop our duty, what we are doing. So it's really clearly explained by Lord in Bhagavad Gita about our actions, what we do in here in this material world. When we are here, what we should do, Lord told very clearly. In the next two verses, we'll understand how we'll do action here when we are, so that we will not suffer or we will not get bondage here. We'll not get bound here in this birth and death life cycle. So first verse we'll see, like there is, Lord explains, all of you might know, and you can recite after me this verse. Most of you know this famous verse. Karmanyeva adhikaraste ma faleshu kadachana ma karma phala heturbur mate sangostva akarmani. Lord says, you have right to perform your prescribed duty, but you are not entitled to the fruits of action. Never consider yourself to be the cause of the results of your activities. Never be attached to not doing your duty. So if you see in the picture, Arjuna was guided by Krishna so nicely. Arjuna, your prescribed duty is to fight. Why are you telling that I will not fight and I'll go for some other forest and I'll live like a renunciate there? No, your duty is to fight. So you have to fight. That is your Kshatriya Dharma. And you should not expect the results. And the what results you are getting, should offer it as to me. That results, whatever you get, should not attach to the results. Correct, no? So it is so nicely guided Arjuna in the battlefield. Similarly, we do our action in this material world. We do an action as a prescribed duty. Like there are different kinds of prescribed duty as per the Lord creation. Kshatriya Dharma, Brahman Dharma, and Vaishya and Sudra. There are different kinds of dharmas Lord has given. So which we have to do our prescribed duty, what is given to us. And we should not expect the results. So, and we are not, we should not attach to the results also. We should do our duty as per the Lord saying here. So that's very important. So in course of time, I'll go to the next important verse in Bhagavad Gita 3rd chapter, 9th verse. It is said, Yajnartat karmano yatra lokoyam karma bandana tadartam karma kaunteya mukta sangha samachara. Very important verse. Has told that work done as sacrifice for Vishnu has to be performed. Otherwise, work causes bondage in this material world. Therefore, O son of Kunti, perform your prescribed duties for his satisfaction. And in that way, you will always remain free from the bondage. So Lord explains so nicely here, correct? So the meaning of this verse is, I'll tell it in a practical way. Like we are doing our actions in this material world. For example, person may work for a company, get some money out of it. So work is my duty, I'm doing it. So nowadays, there is no proper division of Kshatriya, Brahmana, Vaishya, Sudra. All are born Sudras only. So we are all born Sudras. So by our qualities, we'll become Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Sudra by cultivating those qualities. So now we are doing, example, I said, I'm working, I'll get an income out of it. That is the result of my water duty I'm doing. So I'll give it some kind of portion to Lord. Like I'll not expect the results. I'll give some portion of the Lord as a sacrifice to Lord, as an offering to Lord. So like that, we cook something to eat. We offer to Lord. That is offering to Lord. And then we are honoring it. So whatever we do an action, we do as a sacrifice to Lord. To Lord. And then we have it. So then we are not bound here. I told example of eating. I told example of working. So two examples I gave you. When you eat a food, offer it to Lord. As Lord prescribed in Bhagavad Gita. Offer in this kind of foodstuffs. And then you honor it. You will not get any sinful activities. You will not get bound here. So your sinful reactions will be reduced. And also, one more important thing Lord explains, that when you do this kind of activities, what will happen? That seed, actions or reactions, whatever is there, it will be like burnt. Like example, you take a seed, you sow it the seed in the soil, it will germinate. But the same seed, you roast it and then put it, it will never germinate, correct? Like that, the seed of karma cannot germinate if they are roasted in the fires of divine wisdom. Second point, if you see there. So like that, we, whatever action we do, it will not seed our karma, either good results or bad results. If you do the Lord's Lord instructions, if you perform the Lord instructions as it is explained in Bhagavad Gita, like we do work according to the Lord instructions and offer everything as sacrifice to Lord and for his pleasure. So then we will be not bound here, and we will be free from the karma. So we'll go in detail in next section about karma, akarma and vikarma, three types of karma. There you'll understand what is that thing we call as akarma, which we do perform as a part of devotion, which is not make us bound here. Okay. So my humble request to answer the next poll. And very interesting thing, after the poll is we'll do 1 minute of chanting, then we'll start our question answers for today. Yes, Prabhuji. So what we should do, just now we discussed, to summary, like this poll will help us to understand that karma means for every action there is a reaction, we know it. But what we should do, we should do our work as a sacrifice to Lord and please him. That will not make us bound here. Okay. I want all of you to please read through the question and answer so that you will get an understanding. So summary of that, whatever we discussed till now. Yes. 38 if you have answered, I think already. Okay. So thank you so much. So for your poll and answers. So now one more, as I discussed in the recap session of today, that very, very important thing. So that is food for soul. We discussed that which will vanquish all our sinful activities is chanting the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. That is the food for soul. And that is a practical thing. After reading Bhagavad Gita, we should understand, we should start it. So Prabhupada also mentioned in Srimad Bhagavatam, 6th canto, 2nd chapter, 16th verse, explains that chanting the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra will vanquish all the effects of sinful activities what we have done. So my humble request to all of you, let us chant one round along with Prabhupada. So we'll chant 1 minute now. Please chant along with the Prabhupada. It is very simple. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So I'll play the video. So 1 minute, please chant with us. Like very, very important thing, I would like to inform all of you, please carefully hear what you are chanting, every word. It's very simple, right? Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Let's chant for 1 minute, okay? Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna,
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare
Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Rama, Hare Hare.
Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare
Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna. So thank you so much for enthusiastic participation. That's the food for our soul, which you have to give every day. And next tomorrow also we'll chant for 3 minutes. So what's going to have our next session is, we already discussed about the karma, how the karma works, what different types of karma, what is Sanchit karma, what is Prarabdha karma, karma, akarma, collective karma, and how different kinds of examples we'll see in next session. So sorry for exceeding some 10 minutes over here. Let's start the Q&A for today. So Prabhuji, I'll stop sharing. So we can have question answers for now. I hope a lot of questions are there in chat.
Thank you, Prabhuji, for a wonderful class. I have unmuted the devotee line. So devotee can interact directly with me.
Yeah, Hare Krishna. Smriti Keshav Prabhu.
Hare Krishna Prabhu.
Okay. Yeah, so Prabhu, one Mataji was asking at the end. So probably you can take from there, Prabhuji. Okay, how to overcome. Yeah, you can see the chat and you can end the
question. Sure, Prabhu. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Yashasvini Mataji is asking, how to overcome from the worldly desires to be connected to Krishna internally? Prabhuji, should we lose the connection with the peoples and enjoy yourself alone, Prabhuji? No, Mataji. No, it's not like that. So, very good question you asked. Very intelligent question. What we have to do, overcoming from worldly desires means, like worldly desires means we have some necessities which we need. Like for example, like I said about 4 things common, right? So necessities of life we require, we have it. But along with that, we should add spirituality in our life. So what, for example, I'll tell myself, I'm practicing, like I want to know more. I want to connect to Lord more. What I did, slowly, slowly increasing my spiritual capacity. Like for example, we know about chanting now. We start increase our chanting. So we chant attentively, coming to this kind of programs, attending very regularly this kind of programs, associating with devotees and reading books. So taking darshan of deities, this will make us connect internally more and more about Lord. So that doesn't mean that we disconnect from our other people outside, our families or our relationships. No, we should maintain very, very good relationship with others also. Because in the first session, if you see, Prabhupada explained that devotee means you'll have all the good qualities in you. So we should know, like all are souls of Lord. All have internally, they have connection to Lord, but they are all covered. Now we are fortunate that we are understanding these concepts and we understood that we are the part and parcel of Lord. We have to connect ourselves to Lord. That's why we are want to practice this so nicely. So these 4 things we'll learn there, like A, B, C, D, association, B for books, C for chanting, D for diet and deities. So these 4 things we will do it. We'll connect internally to Lord nicely. And we should maintain our relationship with other people also who are around us, such a way that we will be able to practice what we are planning, because we know that this is the highest priority. Now you understood from this concept that this is very important priority, because if you don't give food for our soul, if you don't understand the importance of ourself, then slowly, slowly we will negligent our spiritual life, right? So keeping that in mind, we make association such a way, and also we'll not hurt them. We will always pay respect to everyone and we'll be friendly with everyone. So that's how we should behave very diligently with everyone. And it will happen slowly, slowly. Like we should have patience that they may criticize us, they may initially tell so many things, but they'll understand that this person sincerely want to follow this, whatever he's learning. So let's respect him. The day will come, they'll start respecting you also.
Hare Krishna Prabhu, I have a question. Can I ask?
Yes, Mataji, go ahead.
See, it's regarding a karma, okay? So I have some karma. Is this karma be transferred to my children, whatever I have?
No, Mataji. My understanding, whatever I heard till now, like it's individuals, whatever we have. So okay. Our own karma. So we cannot give our pain to our children. No, whatever we suffer, that pain, if you cut a finger, that pain I have to suffer. That pain cannot be transferred to us.
Okay. So because if they have some sufferings, so is it my karma that has gone to them?
No, their own karma, what I've done in the previous life.
Okay, thank you, Prabhu. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna, Dhanat Pranam, Prabhuji. Prabhuji, you given the example of the Ramayana,
Prabhuji.
So where Bharat Maharaj and Kaikai, So, Prabhuji, we have a lot of problems with, you know, sometimes with our relatives and friends. And so how to overcome such issues? Like, you know, what we can do? That was one question. And another question was karma, whether whatever is the karma, can we change our karma? Huh. And so, like, we might have done bad things in our, you know, previous life or in the same life. So, yeah. What can we do to change our karma?
Yes, Proji. Today we discussed at the end, Proji. I'll repeat again. So, your good name, Proji?
Ravi.
Hare Krishna. Proji, we discussed like end of the session that we want to have action here in this material world when we are there, which will make us to have no karma only. That is called akarma. Akarma means something which will, there is no reaction. That means we are doing devotional activities. Like I told, chanting. Chanting will make us to wipe out all our sinful reactions slowly. But chanting will help us to do that. And as I said, coming into association, reading Bhagavad Gita book, like all these activities, what I told, A, B, C, D, you can remember. Association, books, chanting, deities, and diet. Like having these kind of activities, which are devotional activities, will not have any karma. So all our actions, what we done in the previous life, will be taken away. It will be like, what I can say, if you go to a forest and if you see, lion is the king of forest, correct? When lion comes and roars very loudly, I cannot shout, but when it louds so loudly, roars, all the animals will flee away here and there, correct? Like that, when you chant very attentively, very sincerely, Hare Krishna Mahamantra, our sinful activities will be flown away like the animals. So like that, it will help Roji. And second part, you asked about relatives and other things. As I told Mataji, same thing. We will make friendly environment wherever we go. And when we humbly express our interests, that my humble request is, I am interested to follow this. So I don't want to disturb you, but my interest is to follow this. So they may accept, they may not accept, but they may criticize initially. But by seeing you following very consistently, very regularly, they will respect you one day. That's what I would like to answer for that question, Prabhuji.
Thank you, Prabhuji. Wonderful class, Prabhuji. Thank you very much.
How to control anger? We often lose our intelligence in anger. Ganesh Prabhuji is asking. In anger, hence take unfavorable decisions.
Can I ask one question?
Yes, from Bombay.
I'm from Bombay.
Yes, Prabhuji.
Can I ask one question?
Yes, Prabhuji. Yeah, go ahead, Prabhuji.
Same. I have been following since I've 18th chapters when you were given lecture. I have been reading Bhagavad Gita since 5-6 years, and Bhagavatam also similarly 5-6 years from its one book. Now, after hearing the lecture for 18 days course, I am over interested in learning more about Krishna. Moreover, I spend more time on Narayanam, that is Krishna's only, daily. So it makes me pleasure. It gives my sufferings lessened.
Yes.
So I continue to do it. I will definitely do it. Thank you so much. Your lecture is excellent. Very understanding also. That is very important. Thank you.
Thank you, bro. All the rest is Prabhupada. Thank you,
bro. Roji, can you give a chance to Tanya Mataji? Mataji,
yes, Mataji, go ahead.
Prabhuji, I just want to ask that how can we accept everyone and how can we love everyone like Lord does? Like if we have bad feelings for someone, how can we change it to good feelings? Means for myself, I don't want to keep my mind negative for anyone. So how can we do that?
Prabhuji, you are muted. Prabhuji, you are muted, please.
Yeah, sorry. Thank you, Prabhuji. Tanya Mataji, thank you for a wonderful question. So whatever I understood, what I learned from seniors, like, see, now having no negative thoughts about others, like, why we should not have negative thought about others? The reason is, we understood that all are part and parcel of Lord, correct? Even the animals also, they are part and parcel of Lord. So if you have negative thoughts towards anyone, that means you have negative thoughts towards Lord also, Lord Krishna. Because who are they? They are part and parcel of Lord only. If you want to show love towards Lord, you want to show love towards who are there with you, right? First of all, you have to understand them. You have to be loving nature with everyone who are there with you. You can understand the Lord's love by how you are showing love towards Lord's part and parcels who are there with you, correct? So if you are trying to have negative opinions on others, then how will you have the love towards Lord? Correct? No, that is not possible. So we should cultivate that. Sometimes we may get the thoughts, but to understand by this principle that all are part and parcel of Lord. So, and everyone is looking for that love, correct? Me, you, all the living entities, what they are looking for? Selfless love. Does anyone there in this world who loves me without expecting anything in return? Is there any one person in our life? Correct? No, we are looking for the selfless love, correct? So we should understand that, should practice that. I should be able to give that to others also, Mother. That's what very important.
Yes, Prabhupada. Thank you. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Yeah, Mataji.
Prabhuji, you spoke about the senses. I have a doubt if the senses which we possess belongs to the material body or to our soul, Prabhuji. Does it act according to our soul, or it acts according to what our soul tells, or according to our body, like what our body requires? Like as you said about the food and all those things.
Yes, ma'am. Very, very intelligent question. Very nicely asked. So, you nicely followed it. So the thing is, there are total three layers. First layer is what you are seeing. My eyes, my nose, my mouth, my ears. That is called gross body, which you can see my sensory things, which I'm going to do. Second layer is mind and intelligence and false ego. Okay, that is second layer, which you cannot see. But we all know that we have mind, we have intelligence, we have ego, false ego, correct? Third layer is soul. So because of soul's presence and because of soul falsely identifying that I am belonging to this. So what will happen? Mind will tell that our culprit is mind. So soul has the desires. That's why we got this body, so that we can enjoy. But all the things are stored in our mind, which we cannot see our mind. But mind is subtle. But mind has that experiences. Mind has that unfulfilled desires and thoughts. So mind, what it will do? Mind will tell you that you have to go and enjoy. You have to go and do this. You have to go and do that. It will invoke it. And intelligence will take a decision to do it or not. Example, eating gulab jamun. Like I like to eat gulab jamun. Mind will tell previous experience. Gulab jamun is sweet. You can have it. So intelligence will tell, like we keep on eating 1, 2, 3, 4. When mind tells that, what the sense will do? Oh, gulab jamun smell is coming. Okay, nose, we heard the smell. That is the desire of soul to enjoy, but we falsely identify with this body. No, the mind makes that, telling that gulab jamun you have to eat, it is sweet. So eyes will go there, tongue will eat it, the senses will enjoy it. Enjoy the senses through senses. So intelligence will take a decision. No, you have taken more than enough, stop it. Otherwise will stop, your stomach will get upset. So like understand, Mataji, like that, there are two layers, which is we are seeing the senses, cross senses, through these organs we are working, and mind and intelligence. Mind tells the previous experiences and thoughts. Intelligence gives the decision, and we falsely identify ourselves that we are the body. Actually, we are soul. So the desires of the soul are through the mind, falsely identifying with the mind and intelligence, we act through. Understand, Mataji? It's clear?
Yes, Prabhuji. As you're saying, our sense, our mind will guide us to do, and our intelligence will do that work. So our senses will enjoy it.
Right, Mataji. Yeah. And mind has to be controlled. The main thing is, whatever we have previous thoughts in our mind, that will make us do all these activities. Now what we have to do, that mind should listen to us. Mind should not drag us. For example, a person addicted to drinking, you can observe him, right? How much ever you stop him, he will go to the shop. Why? Because mind is cheating him. You will get happiness there. You go there, you go there, you go there. You will drag him to that. That's why those are called addictions. So mind has to be controlled, saying that mind, you don't listen to the words of mind, telling that mind, you listen to me. My need is, I want to chant Hare Krishna. I want to read Bhagavad Gita. I want to associate with devotees. I want to go to temple. I want to understand more about Lord. So we have to train our mind slowly. That is called Maha Mantra. Manas Trayate Iti Mantra. By chanting, mind can be controlled. So we can control our mind and we can focus on Lord. So that's why we have to chant Hare Krishna every day, which will help us to control our mind and make our senses to serve the Lord. Eyes to see the Lord, nose to smell the Lord's flowers, tulasi, eat prasadam. Like that, when you do chanting, everything will be followed up. So the mind is very, very important. That is what we are identifying now. So we should not identify with the mind. We should take care of it.
Yes, Prabhuji, Hare Krishna. Prabhuji, and one more doubt. Like we have heard that, like, it's true that Bhagavad Gita was born when Krishna spoke it to Arjuna in the battlefield. So, in the first chapter, the previous conversation, like Dhritarashtra, Sanjaya, and Duryodhana, what all they spoke, why is it also mentioned in the Bhagavad Gita? Like, other than the Krishna's next words, like what did Krishna speak? Other than that, why is it mentioned, Prabhuji?
Yeah, good question, Mataji. Actually, if you see Mahabharata Itihasa, it was mentioned that narration of Bhagavad Gita happened in battlefield of Kurukshetra, and the conversation was started by Dhritarashtra. Dhritarashtra sitting in the Hastinapur, asking Sanjaya, Sanjaya, Dhritarashtra uvacha, Dharmakshetre Kurukshetre, Samaveta Yosava, Amaka Pandava Shaiva, Kimakruvata Sanjaya. Kimakruvata Sanjaya. He asking Sanjaya what happened in the battlefield after they assembled. So, like that started, Sanjaya explaining what all happened in the battlefield to Dhritarashtra. That's what how it started, because Bhagavad Gita comes conversation between Dhritarashtra and Sanjaya. That's why it started from there. And if you see at the end, the last verse, Sanjaya says, Yatra Yogeshwara Krishna, Yatra Partha Dhanudhara, Tatra Sri Vishaya Bhutir, Dhruva Nitir Matir Mama. Wherever Krishna is there, wherever Arjuna is there is a victory. So these all verses also included in the Bhagavad Gita, because this comprises the starting of where Bhagavad Gita started and how Sanjaya concluded it. And importance of these things is, there are many more verses which Krishna didn't speak. There are verses where Duryodhana spoke. He's telling in the first chapter, saying that there is Bhishma, there is Bhima, there is so many other people on the Pandava side. He talks to Dronacharya. So there are different kinds of people names coming in the Bhagavad Gita. These are there in Bhagavad Gita, because they are all connected to Lord at that point of time. These are also very important. We have to read them as a part of Bhagavad Gita. So these all verses are also very important, because they are all somehow or other connected to Lord. So we should not never see that separated, because these are connected to Lord. Dhritarashtra, Sanjaya, all these are very powerful souls who are there during that point of time, who are connected to Krishna. So these verses are also very nicely composed and very nicely written by Vedavyas. So we should comprise that also as Bhagavad Gita, as connection to Lord.
Yes, Prabhuji. Hare Krishna, Nanda.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Prabhuji, I want to ask that if we know that people are talking negative about us, if we know everything, the truth, but we have to continue relation with them, or we have to cut it down fully with them.
Hare Krishna. I think a similar question was asked. I was telling that if you see, like, it was completely making you hurt, where you cannot go and talk to them again and again because they are backbiting or they're doing some kind of things. My suggestion is, like I was saying, that all are having their own kind of their own reactions or their karma, which they are behaving currently. So we all understood that. And we also know now we are attending these sessions, that we are understanding that we are soul, part and parcel of Lord. Our eternal constitutional position is always to love, right? We all seek that love. So we understand that they are also part and parcel of Lord. We can show our love towards Lord by showing love towards others also. But I am saying, like, if you are so much of hurt, maybe kind of gap, or you cannot like, if they are so close to you, like your family or something, if they are very far relationship, maybe we meet only once, But if you are in your home, if they are same family, then you have to see them every day, right? Your wife or your father or your mother or sister. Like if you are daily connection with them, understand the aspect of this and try to have the positive thoughts saying that maybe their reaction now acting in this way, which is making them talk like this. But let me, my behavior, my understanding, make me a good person and make me a simple, humble person, which will also make them change in one day or other day. Like that we can pray, Mother. That's what my humble opinion or suggestion.
Prabhuji, I am trying to forgive them and I am normal with them. But all these things made me always think negative, Guruji. Always negative thoughts in my mind, Guruji.
Yes, Mataji.
That's spoiling my mental health also.
Okay. No, yeah, Mataji. So, maybe my humble opinion, like what you are saying is right. Maybe you already done your best of forgiving them and giving them the kind of already you have forgiven them. So my suggestion is that better to already whatever extent you could you do it. My suggestion is you can humbly practice like chanting. You sit and chant peacefully. Make your mind completely free of these thoughts what you have. Telling that, oh Lord, I have done my best. It is your choice now. You do the rest. My best is, I know that they have done mistake and they are blaming me. I have forgiven them. Whatever best I could do, I do it. Oh Krishna, I am completely under you. I am surrender to you. My humble request to you is, I did my best. You take care of the rest. So like that, you should pray to Lord Mother. Intensely you pray to Lord, please help me. And chant very attentively. You take your beats, can take your beats chanting, close your eyes, focus on every mantra hearing very attentively and pray to Lord very intensely, Mataji. That will help you.
Thank you, Guruji. Thank you very much, Guruji.
Hare Krishna. So maybe, yeah, Ganesh Prabhu is asking again. Maybe I missed that question. Prabhuji, I will take this question. It's already crossed 15 minutes. Sorry for that. So there are more questions. One question about how to control anger. So very good question you asked, Prabhuji. Like very important to control our anger. Even sometimes I feel that I have more anger. So we should be always understand that what does this anger lead to? So Bhagavad Gita explains that there are three gateways to hell. One is anger, kama, krodha and lobha. So krodha means anger. So anger leads us to the hell. It takes us to the hell. In the anger state, we don't know what we talk. We don't know what action we do. We don't know what decision we make. So that will be disastrous only. So we should be very, very careful when we get an anger. So we should always think, why, for what purpose I'm angry with other person, correct? What is the reason I'm becoming angry? And we should try to see that my angry is going to make me anything good, right? If I'm going to make anything, I mean, something good for me by becoming angry on him, is something good for me? No, right? I myself am getting hurt by becoming angry, correct? And even after angry on them, shouting on them, later we feel realized that I did a mistake. So whenever you get angry, you can remember what I learned is, you can remember on Lord Narasimha's angry. So I heard it from our seniors, like how Lord Narasimha was so angry on Hiranyakashipu because he tortured Prahlad like anything. So before the angry of Lord Narasimha, what is our anger? So we are so minute. So we should meditate on the anger of Lord Narasimha, anger will be gone. So, and anger is always dangerous to us. I said it will lead to the gateway of hell only. So because we do in anger, we take decisions which will be like disastrous. So we should very, very prayerful to the Lord, especially meditate on Lord Narasimha. So Lord Narasimha Dev angry, just meditate on Narasimha Dev angry, how angry he was when he was trying to kill Hiranyakashipu, protect Prahlad. So that will help you.
Thank you, Prabhuji. Prabhuji, will you take the last question? Omar Prabhu having some question? Prabhuji, that will take the last question and the rest will be taken chat.
Yeah.
Hare Krishna Prabhu.
Hare Krishna
Prabhu.
Yes, Prabhu. Yeah, please go ahead, Prabhu.
Prabhu, suppose in this life, next life, if I become an animal, will I be knowing whether I am in the animal's body? Suppose.
Good question, Prabhu. Actually, we will not come to know, Prabhuji. It's an exceptional case where we'll get to know. Example, Srimad Bhagavatam. That is Bharat Maharaj, who became deer in next life, but he could able to remember his previous lives. So like that, but in our case, we will not able to remember, Prabhuji. So like, for example, we do an activity which will make us to glide down and become an animal in next life. So what will happen? We tend to be there like that. We understand we'll be in illusion saying that that is our family, that is our thing, and we'll stay in animal life. Because animal life, we don't have any kind of karma. We keep on continuing different kinds of species. It's a circle. 84 lakh species are there. Yeah, we keep on gliding down.
So that means if I glide down to an animal species, I'll not know that I'm in an animal species. I'm not in that animal species. That's what true.
If you become an animal, we think that we are animal. That is what we are.
No, like how I'm not. Thinking,
oh, I'm this body. We think that we are the animal, and we lead our life. And our life will be again like kind of eating, sleeping, mating, and defending. And we will continue progressing. Like it will happen like that. Until unless we get again human form of life, we will not get to know only. You will again human form of life only way, again you will be able to think, no, I should not stay here. I'm getting stuck in this birth, old age, and death. I have to go out. I have to go to God. I have to go to my spiritual place where I am coming from.
So that means, Prabhu, for example, suppose next life I become a dog. Suppose I become a dog. I will not know that I'm in a dog's body. Will I know? I will not know. So no. Next, till I get a human birth, I will not know I'm in an animal's life.
Yes. Oh. No. It will pass on, Proji. I told you in a cycle. Like it will go from dog, cat. Like there is a cycle. It goes to horse. Then so. Like if you're normal cycle, it goes like that. There is a cycle. It will go till there, comes to cow body and then human body. Like that. You'll go on keeping on different kinds of animal species.
Prabhu, one question. Yeah. Suppose a man, if he goes to this hellish planets, there, how many years he has to suffer? Suppose hellish planets. If he goes to a hellish planet,
depends. Yes, Proji. Like it depends on our kinds of sinful activities. There are different kinds of hellish planets are there. Like there are different kinds. Like different. There are different regions where in Naraka they suffer, make the people suffer. If you see human lusty, your eyes will be burnt. If you do intoxication, your molten iron is put into your mouth. Like that, based on our activity, we'll suffer for a certain period of time, whatever we do. And also we get training for next life there. And then we'll be sent to our next destination.
That means it may go on for many years, too. 100 years, 50 years, like that.
Based on our sinful activities. Yes.
That is next life, again, we can get a human body. Body.
Yeah, we'll suffer. We'll come back. We'll take body of animal. We'll continue the cycle. We will continue the animal cycle like that and then come to human form of life. That time we'll have a choice again, whether to again decide now, go back to Godhead, or again continue this 84 lakh species again.
And Prabhu, one more thing. Suppose all these Krishna conscious devotees will go to Goloka Vrindavan or they will go to other planets also, Prabhu?
Prabhu, this actually, this topic what we are discussing about going to spiritual world and different kinds of planets. Yes. Discussion is there in 6th session in detail, like spiritual world and material world. As a short answer, like whatever we practice, Hare Krishna Mahamantra, we practicing that wherever we are, want to love and serve the Lord. And our goal is to go back to God. It may be Vaikuntha, or it may be Ayodhya, it may be Jagannath Puri, it may be Mathura, it may be anywhere. So we are happy to love and serve the Lord.
So what I learned from some devotees is, from which planet we have fallen, we'll go to that planet only. Suppose I have fallen from Vishnu Loka. I want to go to Goloka Vrindavan, Krishna Loka. I can't go because I have from Vishnu Loka I have fallen. So I'll be going to Vishnu Loka only. That's what they are telling some devotees. What is your take on this, Prabhu?
My relation is not much, Prabhuji. My understanding is whatever Prabhupada has given, we'll follow it. Rest all Prabhupada will take care. Once our life is over, whatever Prabhupada said, we'll follow it. Because his Acharya, founder Acharya of ISKCON, Srila Prabhupada, has given us certain instructions to follow. We follow so nicely reading Bhagavad Gita and instructions. At the end of life, whatever happened, Prabhupada will take care. Whether Vaikuntha or spiritual world, wherever Prabhupada will engage us in our service world. That's what my opinion.
I just wanted to know, all these Krishna conscious devotees will go to Goloka Vrindavan or they may go to other planets? That's what I wanted to know.
Yeah, Guruji. I don't know. My relation is that much. But based on, that is because we did our endeavor, then the decision is Lord's, no, Guruji. Understanding, right? Lord has to take the decision on for us.
So suppose I go to Vishnu Loka from there, can I not go to Krishna Loka? Suppose I'm put into Vishnu Loka.
Can we have offline?
Suppose I'm going to Vishnu Loka. I'll go to Vishnu Loka. From there, I can't go to Krishna Loka, Prabhu. Goloka Vrindavan.
So internal transfer, you're asking, like from Vaikuntha Loka to Goloka Vrindavan, you want to transfer.
Suppose.
So, Prabhuji, that's what. Like, you definitely please attend the 6th session. Don't miss it. Our Sankarshita Tayyip are going to take the session. So it's very interesting where we discuss about spiritual world, where there are different kind of Vaikuntha Loka, whether we can go from a not. Please don't miss it. I'd like to go to other questions also. There many questions are there.
So we'll Prabhuji, thank
you, Prabhu. Thank you.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna.
Prabhuji, why are we experiencing this? Coming to life, fight here, whether to please the God or again take 84 lakh round and come into human life. Every time I get depressed about this. What is this life? Why are we coming?
So your question is like, why are we coming, Prabhuji? That is your question, or why we are
Why are we experiencing all this?
Okay. Prabhuji, as you saw Gaur Gopal Prabhu's video, right? Prabhuji explained so nicely.
Yeah.
It is said, we are the person who make our destiny, right? What are actions we did? That's why we are here now. Exactly. For example, if I envy a person, envy means I'm trying to do something hard with that person. If I'm envying that person. So what will happen? I will try to do an action where it will make him damage his fame, damage his wealth. I'll do that kind of actions, correct? So my action, what I did now, it will definitely give me a reaction. Correct? Understanding, Prabhuji? So we are experiencing here in this life all these things because of our own actions. We have that desire that I want to enjoy independent of the Lord. I want to enjoy or control independent of the Lord. I want to control myself. I am the enjoyer. I am the controller. But we never thought that we are not like that, actually. Our eternal consciousness position is always to love and serve the Lord. Without doing that, like that prodigal son, the story I told you, the son is stubborn. I want to enjoy. Give my share. We are also told the Lord, you be there. Okay. I also want to enjoy. So let me get my share and enjoy myself in my material world. I have my own home. I have my own family. I let me enjoy my own independent way. But as I said, we cannot be like that. We have to be connected to Lord only. Lord, unwillingly, Lord doesn't want to send us, but we forced him. You send me. I have to go. Let me go here and experience it. I want to enjoy independent of you. I want to forget you. I don't want you only. So like that, we told him. Lord told, no, you cannot. But Lord told, no, I'll come with you. Lord is there with us in the super soul. Now he's observing us. So we desired it. We don't want you. Now we'll desire. Lord, I want you. I don't want anyone. I want you. So we'll decide that, Lord, I want you. I want to come with you. I want to be with you. Then super soul will turn towards us and will give us the direction. So we'll never feel depressed. Lord is there with you always as super soul. So Lord will guide you. So attending these sessions will help us to understand more about Lord, Lord's compassion. Lord, what is giving us is so valuable. Chanting, reading books, association is so valuable, Prabhuji. There is no depression kind of here. You will really blissfully, you will experience your life because you are coming in touch with the Lord now.
Thank you, Prabhuji. Thank you. And Prabhuji, another question. Tomorrow is Ekadashi. And how Ekadashi is different from another 14 days? I have listened to so many stories, Krishna saying to Yudhishthira about many Ekadashis, you should observe Ekadashi. How is Ekadashi different from another 14 days? And why should we observe fasting? And why it is given a special place?
Yeah, probably. Early time crossed, but I want to answer this in short. So that I'll do one more. Mati is also asking there. So after this question, I'll wind up the session, Prabhuji.
Sure.
Yeah. So as you asked about Ekadasi, even I was thinking in that way only. When I heard about Ekadasi 10 years back, 2010 up to 11, what is Ekadasi? Why it is so special? What Lord does on this day? Why it is so special? As I told, no one is so compassionate as Lord. So compassionate. So although you told him, I don't want you, still is be with you as super soul. Like that, Lord is so compassionate that soul has come to his material world, he is suffering here. So he saw that not only suffering here, as Prabhuji said, they are going to hellish planets and suffering there also. Lord, when he was just went visit to Yamadharmaraj, and he saw people are crying, shouting, yelling because of their desires, they are suffering. They did all kinds of sinful acts. Lord felt compassionate. So what is this? They are suffering like anything. So all the lot of things are probably, but they're having their desires independent of me. So Lord thought, out of this compassion, Lord has given us an opportunity called Ekadasi days. So, where Lord told on this day, whoever does Ekadasi Vrata, like kind of, which called Ekadasi means what? Ekadasi means 11th, Eka means 11. So, actually, on that day of, actually that day what happens, Lord out of compassion told us, whoever does the this Vrata, what they will do is, their all sins will be taken away. And that day, what we have to do is, we have to do more and more devotional activities. So, from the Lord, actually the manifest Ekadasi form of the Lord. So, goddess form of the Lord. And compassion of that Lord is that form, which will help us following the Vrata on that day to come out of the sinful acts. There is two versions of this story. Like one is about killing a demon called Mura, where this Ekadasi version of the Lord, from the Lord, the compassion comes as Ekadasi, and she is the goddess of that Ekadasi main Vrata, and she fought with Mura demon and she killed him. He's a personification of sin. So all kinds of sinful activities. And as discussed that, person on this Ekadasi who are follow Vrata, the Mura demon, all the sins, what are there, which will be there in the form of grains. It will be there in the form of grains. Because if they whoever follows Ekadasi Vrata on the day following the Vrata of Lord, they will not get any sin and they will not go to hell. So Lord told, there are not many, Emerald told, there are not many service for me. So then Lord told that as Mura demon killed, whoever does eating grains on this day, they'll get all the sins. So he explained that and everyone should follow Ekadasi Vrata. So what Vrata Lord explained here is, the main understanding of the Vrata is, whoever follows this Ekadasi Vrata, they will can do chanting more, reading more, and they can hear more about Lord. So that is called Upavasa. Upa means coming close to Lord. Upavasa means Upavasa, coming close to Lord. So we do fasting from grains, and we do eating fruits, sabadan, eating different kinds of non-grain things. And that means which will make our cooking less time and focus more on chanting, reading, and hearing more about Lord. That will make us come close to Lord. That's the main goal, Prabhuji. That's Lord's compassion for us. He has given that day for us.
Thank you, Prabhuji. Thank you so much. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. So, actually, already crossed 9. So, maybe what are questions are there which are not answered, I would request, we both will sit, myself, Sankarshan Dai Prabhu, Akshay Prabhu, we all sit. We'll make a list and we'll try to find the time to answer these questions. But I would like to thank everyone for your enthusiastic participation, the session and question answers. So if I have spoken anything wrong, please forgive me. So knowing or unknowingly, for my humble request. So please attend the next
session. Guruji, where you will send the answers?
Mataji?
Where you will send the answers of the written questions in the chat? Please tell me.
Sure, we'll help you, Mataji. We'll take the chat. So myself, Sankarshan Tai Prabhu, Akshay Prabhu, we'll try to get the chat. We'll write down the questions. We'll try to answer all the questions by end of the sessions. Fine, Mataji.
Thank you very much.
So, Hare Krishna. Thank you all. So, please attend tomorrow's session. Don't miss. So, Sankarshan Tai Prabhu will take tomorrow's session. So, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna,
Guruji. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.